Okay, so vitamin D, vitamin E, vitamin K. What's the other one? A, right. These are fat soluble, and they actually work together as a team. How much is off the team? Literally, they all affect certain gene patterns, the same gene pattern. They're all working and affecting it. That's how much of a team they are. D is getting a lot of press these days. Vitamin D is a tremendous immune stimulator and moderator. In the immune systems, it's, you know, vitamin D receptors are just all over the immune system. Some people estimate if we have adequate vitamin D, 70%, it helps protect against 70% of cancer of all types. That's a pretty good immune statement right there, isn't it? 70%? I would say that's pretty good. It also helps with mental functioning. It helps protect against senility. It helps with bone. But not as directly. See, without K, vitamin E brings it in, but it will deposit calcium anywhere. One of the worst places, it deposits calcium in the arteries, right? K says, no, K directs where the calcium for D goes. It brings it into the bones. In other words, you need K to direct it. And the best K is MK-7. We do carry it. It's really, what?
No, and doctors do exactly the opposite. When you have, like, when your blood is, they tell you not to take any formulas, not eat any lettuce. I've heard it, like, and you're saying it's the opposite, because then there's going to be more calcium deposits.
Right. K directs D, the calcium. MK7, it's a British spy agency, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Now, MK7 is the specific form of vitamin K that's the most potent and the most active. And we do carry it, and it is in a capsule. Okay. K2 you get from the vegetable, you know, just eating vegetables. But it doesn't, it helps more with clotting. Anti-clotting, or it acts as a coagulant, but we're talking MK7, which is really about directing the calcium. Vitamin D is important in the regulating the secretion of insulin. Low D has been associated with type 1 and type 2 diabetes. So, with the diabetes, we really make an effort to make sure people get adequate vitamin D. It also has a hormone, calcitonin, and what that does is it kind of regulates kind of growth and also the balance of calcium and phosphorus in the system. So that's just, again, another thing that happens with it. D seems to be very important in protecting against neurological disorders. The most famous of that is multiple sclerosis, which is something that tends to happen more in colder, less sunny climates. Sun is the main way of getting vitamin D, right? Well, yeah, well, there's reasons for that, but just hold on. You know, I want to get back to vitamin D is made by the sun. If you get 20 minutes a day of sunlight for 3 days, you're going to start taking in about 20,000 units a day. Now, what is really happening when you ask that question is maybe people aren't getting so much sunlight. Maybe we're too much inside playing with our computers. But here's where we go to protocol. The best levels are between 50 and 70 in the blood. To really see how you're doing, you really need to check it a few times. Now there's a question of, well, how much should you have? You know, 400 milligrams, 10,000 units. And I think it's variable. Myself, I had been taking 10,000, and I was in low normal vitamin D. Well, I don't want to be low normal. I want to be optimal. So now I'm taking more. Now, that's more than they recommend. Now, what's the point? I'm out in the sun. I could get, 20 minutes of full body sun all the time. I live in Arizona. So what's happening is there's a very big variation. And the only way to do it correctly is, get your sunlight, take your certain amount of vitamin D, and get a blood test.
Try and error until you find...
Until you find the right level. It takes about 3 blood tests to figure it out. The other thing is, people with darker skin absorb less vitamin D. So if you're Afro-American, you will be getting less vitamin D from the sun. It's a protective device, but not so good. So they actually need to supplement more. And I think you want to look at Israel. You have more dark-skinned people. They're more likely to have a lower vitamin D because of the genetic part of that. So that's part of the answer, too. Computers and darker skin.
How long do we need to be
vitamin D? What I was saying is 20 minutes a day should be sufficient. For myself, I get 20 minutes. I'm out in the sun without much clothes or any clothes. 20 minutes, and I take vitamin D supplement. And my vitamin D is low normal. So what I'm trying to say, there's a little bit of trial and error. So the protocol is get a standard. Take 10,000 a day, do what you're doing, and then measure it and see where you stand. Oh, it's too low. It's too high. Well, fine. It's too high, I take less.
If it's too high, what can happen?
Well, if you can get a calcification in your tissues. Excess calcification. And you can get a little, I'm going to say, vitamin D toxicity, but 10,000 is a safe place. People basically, somewhere between 2,000 and 10,000 is pretty safe, where you should be doing your experimenting.
How do you translate that to drops? Or?
Well, in the DC we have, it's 2,200 per drop.
Drop. What would be?
Well, 10 drops is going to give you 10 or 11,000.
So 10 drops a day?
I would start at 5 a day.
5 drops a day.
And that's going to give you about 10,000 units. One drop is 2,000.
1 drop is 2,000.
5,000. No, 5 is 10,000.
No, I thought it was 1,000.
Yeah.
My life, my mother is telling me to keep away from the sun in the hottest hours, whatever. And like less than a year ago, somebody said that the only way you can absorb the vitamin D is if the sun is perpendicular to the ground, which is a bad hour.
No, I don't think it's like that. If you just get out, obviously the more when the sun's hotter, it's better. If you live in U.S., they say between San Francisco and Baltimore, which is kind of the lower part of the United States in a way, above that line, everybody should take a vitamin D supplement. What's the point? You got to be out in the sun. When you're northern, if you're up near Lebanon, it's going to be not as much sun quality as down here. But still, between 10 and 2 is reasonably good. but the truth is, it's kind of, you have to do trial and error, really. And the only way you're going to get accurate is do a blood spot test. You know, you can just take a blood, we have it at the tree. You just prick your finger and you do the blood spots, and then they...
Like a litmus paper or something?
No, it's paper, and you have to send it in. Ah. Or they can draw your blood, but it's more expensive to do it that way.
The vitamin D, it's just vitamin D the drops, or with the vitamin K?
No, just D. The D and K don't really come together.
So where do we get MK-7?
We carry it. And you just need one capsule a day.
Okay.
And that's going to get you depositing the calcium in your bones, not in your tissues or in your heart. That's not what you want. Yeah.
Could speak more about the dosage, because I don't think people are familiar with the dosage here. In Israel, you have the drug, which is 400 units.
And now
200 to 400. Most people, they don't take it all, or they take maybe two drugs, which are 800. And there is a law in Israel now. They took off the shelves the one with 1,000. Now there is only 400. It is not allowed to take it. They are not in the shelf, the 1,000.
They're not allowed in the shelf.
Okay, and so, and the people that they take vitamin D maximum with doctor order, 2,500 maybe, and you're talking about 10,000, which is...
It's being totally safe.
Yeah, so, okay.
According to the research. It's not revolutionary, it's...
No,
the world research says mostly people to take 10,000 is going to be totally safe. Again, the only way you're going to know is what? Get the blood test. Then you'll know where you stand. The high normal is 50 to 70. You need to be 50 or 70 to get optimal effect. That's it. Now, is there a philosophical point to this? Yeah, there is. Wait a minute, please. Here's the thing I want you to understand. If you're getting really adequate D, what does that mean? It means you're going to have a great immune system. It means you're going to be really healthy. It means you're not going to, you know, your chance of getting cancer is greatly cut down. Your chance of getting diabetes is greatly cut down. You're going to have less colds and flus. You're actually going to be healthy.
So they don't want that.
I just left it with that. So they're always trying to find the minimum for what? Hypothetical minimum. And we know, the research is very clear, 50 to 70 is what you need in your blood. That's it. It's not that complicated. So whether you need 15,000 or 10,000 or 5,000 or 1,000, that is what you have to figure out. Now, one of the things you look at is if people used vitamin D, you don't need vaccinations anyway, but 0 to 4% of vaccinations work. And some of that research is done in Israel, believe it or not. You know, for the flu, it's 0 to 4% effective. Well, I can tell you the vitamin D is a whole lot more effective than that and a whole lot more safe. So you got to understand what is really happening in the world today. There is an explicit movement against anything that's going to make you healthy. Why? You know, if you take vitamin D, you shouldn't even think about taking vaccinations. Do you see what I'm trying to say? So there is definitely a struggle going on, and it's what about those who want health, culture of life, and those who want you to be in ill health so you can have to buy their medicines. That's really what's going on, without allowing me to... No, you had a question.
Yes.